My name is Pablo Ezquerro from the Geological Survey of Spain. One of the research lines of the Spanish Geological Survey INSAR lab is related to the detection, monitoring and modeling of land subsidence using INSAR data and geomechanical models. Since land subsidence is usually considered as a local problem, this work aims to change from local scale studies to a global perspective that focuses on the conditioning factors of land subsidence to perform a global assessment. Combining information from detected subsidence areas, geological and geographical factors, and the influence of groundwater use, global subsidence susceptibility and potential maps were calculated using a statistical analysis based on frequency ratios. The most significant results are that potential subsidence is high or very high over 2.2 million square kilometers, 1.6% of the global surface, and 1.2 billion inhabitants, 19% of global population. As a general overview, potential subsidence is higher over the large aquifer systems of Asia and North America, coastal and deltaic areas of Asia and Europe, and inland basins of North America and the Mediterranean basin. On the other side, potential subsidence is concentrated all over Africa, Australia, and South America, with a few exceptions in the Mediterranean coast and the specific basins of Argentina and Australia. It's important to say that the model calculates the probability that subsidence could happen, not that it's currently happening. Regarding the limitations, the higher probability does not imply higher magnitude. In order to calculate magnitude, specific data and piezometric levels and soft soil thickness are very important and difficult to obtain as global layers. In this work, INSAR has been a fundamental part of the study. 74 of the 182 scientific and technical publications used this monitoring technique to define land subsidence areas. Moreover, 62 of those areas were polygonized and analyzed to define the training areas around the 200 land subsidence records. After obtaining the final maps, potential subsidence have been compared with already studied areas with land subsidence detected with INSAR. 6 selected areas in Spain, Italy, Mexico, China, and Indonesia show that 99% of the areas have probability values over medium high to very high, and 84% are high or very high levels. In these areas, it's also seen that the small basins, usually surrounded by ranges, are very well defined and present high spatial correlation. Over the large basins, high potential areas are usually larger than detected subsidence. This behavior is related to the fact that the map estimates that subsidence could happen, not that it's currently happening. In short, those areas have a high probability to subside, but there should be a trigger to develop it. Taking these potential and limitations, the resulting global map can be used to begin new studies over undetected areas with high potential, especially in those areas with flood risk. Also, facing the new oncoming massive INSAR data like the European Ground Motion Service, this kind of maps could also help to interpret and identify possible triggers of detected displacements. Last, we also aim to increase the visibility of this geological risk and the problems associated to it. An effective land subsidence policy should include systematic monitoring and modeling of the exposed areas, evaluation of potential damages, and cost-benefit analysis allowing implementation of adequate mitigation or adaptation measures. Thank you for your attention.